Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 50 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show, selected especially for public television.
Hello, I'm Charlotte Devaney. This is my musical partner. Lawrence Welk always introduced us as Charlotte and her Jello. Well, of course, everyone laughed at this, including Mr. Welk. The cello and I have known each other for a very long time. In fact, since I was 4 and a half years old. So I feel we know each other very well. I feel I know you very well out in the audience, too, even though this is my first time as host of the weekly series. The show we have tonight is wonderful. It's called Themes from the Classics. And you would be surprised at how many popular song hits have their roots in the classics. My roots are in the classics, too. My mother was Armie Draper, who was a concert violinist, and I loved to hear her practice at night. In fact, before I was born, my mother and her twin sister had the Draper School of Music in a suburb of Chicago. My sister Elizabeth played the violin, and I used to go to the grammar school orchestra rehearsals. I loved to hear that orchestra play, and I begged my mother to give me an instrument so I could play in the orchestra too. One day I grabbed my sister's violin, I ran through the house, and I fell on it. My mother gave me an instrument I couldn't run with, so cello it was. The cello and I have had many adventures together, and I'll tell you about some of them just as soon as Mr. Welk tells you about this wonderful and unique show.
Thank you. Thank you. Wow. Thank you very, very much, my friends. Greetings, everyone. So very glad you could join us for this very special musical program, Themes from the Classics. I know you will enjoy these famous and popular melodies. First, we bring you music by Tchaikovsky, the Concerto in B flat minor. Thank you. Great. Excellent. Bob Ralston and Bob Smale. What great musicianship. And that melody was made famous by bandleader Freddie Martin under the title Tonight We Love. Now here's our lovely champagne lady, Norma Simmer and Jimmy Roberts, with a song which was originally titled Andantino in D flat by Lamar. I'm sure you folks know it better in its present form. Song. The great Polish composer Frederick Chopin wrote many beautiful melodies which later became popular songs. Here's Arthur Duncan dancing to one of Chopin's big hits.
Duncan is just fabulous. Can you imagine seeing someone tap dance to a Chopin melody? I'm Always Chasing Rainbows could have been my theme song in the early days. I did get to play in the Grand Orchestra. I was 5 years old, and they let me in even though I hadn't started school yet. Each year, we competed in the Illinois District and State Contests, and brought back a lot of first place medals. When I was in the sixth grade, I was asked not to compete against, so as to give someone else a chance at winning. I was very disappointed, but I picked up my cello and decided, well, I'll be a professional. My sister and I already had a trio with a friend who played piano, and we began playing for arts clubs, country clubs, all the organizations around our town in the Chicago area. We got a taste of what applause was like and to actually get paid for doing something that we love to do. Frankly, I think Mr. Welk felt the same way about his work.
For their dance this evening, our outstanding young dance couple picked the fairly recent composition, the Welk Concerto, already accepted as a classic in its field. Sissy and Bobby are joined by Bob Ralston. Great music. Our wonderful young clarinet man, Henry Quest, is always ready with something appropriate, no matter what the theme of our show happens to be.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's an operatic selection that really swings.
Doesn't it? It kind of helps to have somebody like Henry Cuesta playing it, doesn't it?
Sure does. Guy, why don't we dedicate our song tonight to all the people celebrating anniversaries this month?
Well, why don't we just make it this year and try to make everybody happy?
That sounds great to me.
Here's our version of the anniversary song, which is based on the composition Danube Waves.
Song, I think of my mother and father who were married over 50 years. My dad, Lester Earl Perry, was a very successful businessman, but he played piano by ear and had a beautiful baritone voice. I think I inherited music from both sides of my family. Maybe that's why I was so anxious to get out into the musical field. When I was 17, after 3 years of high school, I entered Northwestern University. And at 19, I auditioned for the San Antonio Symphony Orchestra, and I became its youngest member. My college professors offered to give me private instruction for those 5 months of work that I would miss while I was away with the symphony. When I came back to college, I was offered a position teaching in Park Ridge, Illinois. I had 150 class piano students, 30 private piano and cello students, 6 string classes, and occasionally I conducted the school orchestra. Well, thoroughly exhausted, I graduated from Northwestern at 21, and I was excited about the musical future. I always wanted to be a member of the Chicago Symphony, but they soon told me that they didn't hire women. So in 1952, I moved to Los Angeles, and it was several years later that I met Lawrence Welk, the man who would change my life forever, the man responsible for this wonderful organization.
Thank you.
you, folks. Thank you very kindly, and thank you, Sissy.
Thank you.
Oh, you are a marvelous dancer. The music you folks just heard was one of my very favorites, Moonlight Madonna, taken from a composition titled Poem. Here's a song I remember as Glühwürmchen.
What is that?
Glühwürmchen. Can you say that? It's a German song.
Glühwürmchen?
Not quite. No. Glühwürmchen. It was made into a popular song with some wonderful lyrics by Johnny Mercer and a great recording by our very good friends, the famous Mills Brothers. Let's listen to our new girl trio, Sandy, Gail, and Mary Lou.
I think that's enough of the glowworm business. How about lights out?
Well, good, because I think my battery's getting low.
Oh, no. Cutie. Well, let's relax, girls, and listen to a beautiful Chopin nocturne. Charlotte and the orchestra are going to play the popular version, My Heart Still Remembers.
members is a very appropriate song for me as I tell you how I became a member of the Lawrence Welk Orchestra. After I moved to Los Angeles, I began working for the movie and recording industries. And one day, Dave Pratt, who was the cellist in the Lawrence Welk band at the time, told the rest of the orchestra that he was going to leave the band. So I called the concertmaster of the Lawrence Welk Orchestra and told him I'd like to see about this job. He said, I think they've already decided on someone, but why don't you come down to the Aragon Ballroom and audition for Mr. Welk? That was March of 1961, and I happily played solos for Lawrence Welk for the next 17 years. Also a busy mother with two daughters, Charlotte and Kathy. And Kathy is engaged to a very wonderful young man. They both live in California, and they enjoy so much watching the old Lawrence Welk shows on public television. It was such a wonderful time of their young childhood years.
One of the most beautiful of all classical themes is the famous Largo from the New World Symphony by Dvorak. You may know it better by its popular title, Going Home. And your conductor, our own George Cates. Come in, George.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Beautiful music. And George, an excellent arrangement. We're all very proud of you. Ken Deal is next in our classic spotlight with a song based on an Italian composition. Ken, take it away.
Yes, the original Italian title of this was Mattinata, but the modern version, we all know it, is called You Break My Heart. You're Breaking My Heart. And it was written by the man who also wrote Pagliacci. And his name was Ruggiero Leoncavallo. If I can say that, I can say almost anything.
You're breaking my heart 'cause you're leaving. You've fallen for somebody new. It isn't too easy believing you'd leave after all we've been through. It's breaking my heart to remember the dreams we depended upon. You're leaving a slow dying ember. I'll miss you, my love, when you're gone. I wish you joy, though teardrops burn. But if someday you should want to return, please hurry back and we'll make a new start. Till then, you're breaking my heart.
Thank you very much. Pretty Gail Farrell from Durant, Oklahoma, has a very impressive background when it comes to classical music. In fact, Gail was attracted to the piano at a very early age. Isn't that right, Gail?
It sure is, Ken. I guess I started playing the piano when I was about 3 years old. And very soon afterward, when I started taking piano lessons, right from the very first, there was really a generation gap between my piano teacher and me. Because you see, she only wanted me to play the three B's. Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms. But I wanted to play some of those new songs I was hearing on the radio. So one day I came up with an idea. Why couldn't I take one of those new songs and give it just a little bit of a classical flavor? Bridge that generation gap. Then my teacher'd be happy and I'd be happy too. Well, it worked. And it worked so well that I was still able to play the three B's. Only this time, it was Bach, Beethoven, and Bacharach. Now I began with Mr. Bach. Then I added Bacharach to Bach. Got to get Mr. Beethoven into the act. And then, of course, there's the cadenza.
Gail, I'm so glad you came up with the three B's. It gave us an idea for this complete show here this
That's
evening.
That's right. Thank
and we're
you.
So happy with the work that you're doing for us. We're very, very pleased.
Well, thank you, Mr. Welk. I just want you to know, along with all of our viewers, what a truly rewarding experience it's been to be with your musical family these 3 years.
Well,
and I
you.
Am really looking forward to the future and hope that I'll always be able to contribute something of value to your show. I really thank you for having me
here. Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice?
That was a very clever medley. And you could see that Lawrence Welk truly admires Gail's many talents. I rarely write a music arrangement, but I do write short stories, and many of them have been published. My first series, called Views from the Bleachers, tell about all different events that I have encountered in my many years of teaching, all told in a humorous vein. My latest series is called Moments in Time, and this tells about the great artist that I was privileged to meet over my many years of studying and becoming a professional. As Rachmaninoff, Fritz Kreisler, Pablo Casals, Yehudi Menuhin, so many, many more. Mr. Welk always thought his musicians should have a varied musical background, so he encouraged us to study and listen to classical music.
This next song is an adaptation of the waltz from the Coppelia Ballet. And if you recall, a few years back, it was a popular song of the day called Pretending. Gentlemen.
Hearts are gay when they play at pretending. If you're blue, why don't you try pretending? After all, aren't we all idle schemers? What is life but a world full of dreams? You're not poor, not when you're make-believing. So if you have blue moments to spend, close your eyes and you'll see how surprised you will be if you just pretend. Close your eyes and you'll see how surprised you will be if you just pretend.
I think very, very relaxing. Here's a wonderful gentleman who has been a great help to me and our musical family for 22 years. And what a great accordion player. Let's listen to our happy Norwegian Myron Floren and his fine arrangement of the well-known classic, The Dance of the Comedians. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You know, in this part of the show, it seems like the Scandinavians are kind of taking over. So it gives me kind of a double pleasure to introduce this next selection. The song is based on a melody by the great Norwegian composer Edvard Grieg and the performer, another famous Norwegian, Norma Zimmer.
What a nice love song, and sung so beautifully by Norma Zimmer. Love does work in very strange ways, doesn't it? My husband died in 1988 after a very long illness. A few years later, I was at a musical gathering and I met Deveni, a concert pianist. He was a widower and neither one of us were looking. But it was love on the first date, and we were married a few months later. This past year, we've just celebrated our 10th anniversary. I'd like to have you meet him now as we play one of our favorite hymns, In the Garden.
Thank you.
This next beautiful melody was originally called Londonderry Air. When words were added, it became one of the best known and best loved of all Irish songs. Here is Joe Feeney to sing it for you, and I taught Myron how to play the accordion on this number.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. It's you must go and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadows, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. It's I'll be here in sunshine or in shadows. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so.
At Harris Club in Lake Tahoe, our show followed Perry Como's, and what a great show he had. I visited Perry in his dressing room just before his last show, and I admired the beautiful red robe he was wearing. The next night when we opened, I found the robe in my dressing room, a gift from Perry. Well, this is a roundabout way of leading into our next number. A few years ago, Perry had a hit recording of a novelty song based on a Spanish rhapsody. And here it is, featuring Clay Hard and all of our singers.
Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? It's so new to me. What you do to me? Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? When you're holding me tight.
Never dreamed anybody could kiss that away, bring me bliss that away, with a kiss that away. What a wonderful feeling to feel that away. Tell me, where have you been all my life?
Oh, hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? It's so new to me. What you do to me? Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? When you're holding me tight.
Never knew that my heart could go zing that away, ting-a-ling that away, make me sing that away. Said goodbye to my troubles, they went that away, ever since you came into my life.
Oh, hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? It's so new to me. What you do to me? Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? When you're holding me tight.
There's a cute little cottage for two that away. Skies are blue that away. Dreams come true that away. If you say I can share it with you that away, I'll be happy the rest of my life.
Oh, hot diggity, diggity, boom, what you do to me? It's so new to me. What you do to me? Hot diggity, dog ziggity, boom, what you do to me? How my future will shine from the moment you're mine.
There's a song that proves that classical music can be lighthearted too. What a wonderful show. I hope you all enjoyed it as much as we did. Shortly after Edwin and I were married, we founded the DeVinny Music School, and we both teach 6 days a week, almost all year long. It's so wonderful to see these little 5 and 6 year olds start out and progress to wonderful things and enjoy it along the way.
One of Charlotte's students played a cello concerto with the symphony orchestra locally just a few months ago. And one of the students is over in Vienna, Austria to play a piano concerto with symphony.
As for performing ourselves, we have very little time with our busy teaching schedule, but when we do, we work with a very fine violinist named Elmer Sue, and our group is called the Concert Trio. Perhaps you've seen our CD. Music is and always will be our life. Right, Edwin?
I'm sure it will be.
Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to be part of our public television viewing audience next week. Goodbye.